Okay, so today we're going to learn about fuse charts and fuse curves. And what we'll do is we'll look at average melt time for a typical fuse, which is shown here. And then also we'll look at current limiting fuses as well. So let's first look at the different axes of the chart. At the top, we have the amp rating, and this is the amp rating of the actual fuse. At the bottom, we have current in amps, and this is the fault current down here. So if there was 10,000 amps of fault current, that would be represented here. And then on the left-hand side, we have time in seconds. And this represents the trip time of the fuse to open the circuit. So when basically the circuit is de-energized, how long will it take? The other thing we want to consider quickly is that this is a logarithmic scale. So basically it compresses as it goes along. So if this is 1,000, this line right here, then this line is 2,000, then 3,000, then 4,000, and so on until we get to 10,000. And then from here, the scale changes. So if this is 10,000, this is now 20,000, 30,000, 40,000, 50,000, 60,000, and all the way up until we get to 100,000. Okay, so let's look at an example. Let's say we have our 800 amp fuse. So we have to look at this line right here. And then let's say we have a fault current of around 3,000. So if this is 1,000, then 2,000, 3,000, okay. So this is our fault current. All we do is we follow the fault current all the way up to where it intersects this 800 amp current line. And it's going to do so right around here. So we follow this over, and we see that if this is 10 seconds, this is 20 seconds, so we're going to be around 18 seconds. So at 800 amps fuse, and at 3,000 amps fault current, the fuse will trip after approximately 18 seconds. Let's look at a second example. If we have the same 800 amp fuse, but this time we apply 6,000 amps fault current. Okay, so 6,000 amps fault current. We follow the line up until it intersects with the 800 amp line, and it intersects right around here, 0, 3, 5 seconds. So we see that the 800 amp fuse at 6,000 fault current amps will blow after 0.035. At half the amount of fault current, it'll blow at 18 seconds, and here it'll blow almost instantaneously. So then, really this graph applies to any of the fuses of this class. So if we had a 4,000 amp circuit, or fuse, we would look at this line, and then we would look at the time down here and do the same thing. We just go up till we hit it, and then go over to determine the seconds to blow. So that's the basics of an average melt time for a fuse. Every fuse classification has its own chart on their website. All right, so if the fuse is a current limiting fuse, then it'll have a second chart. And what this does is it tells us how many amps will actually get through the fuse before it trips. So a normal non-current limiting fuse will just let all the fault current through it until it trips. In this case, though, it'll only let a subset of it through. The region that it's affected is defined by these lines right here. And what we're going to look at first is the left-hand side. This is the instantaneous peak let-through current. Normally, we're not concerned with this. But what we are usually concerned with is the symmetrical RMS amps that get through. Okay, so we're going to do an example of an 800 amp fuse. So first we're going to look at the amp rating of the fuse, which would be here. So we would be interested in this line. And then we're going to say that there's going to be 100,000 fault current amps. So we're going to look over here. And then we're going to see where the fault current intersects the 800 amp line, which is going to be right around here. And then we're going to go all the way over to where it intersects the AB line, which is going to be somewhere around here, right? So AB. And then what we're going to do is we're going to drop straight down to right around here. So there's going to be around 21, 22 maybe kiloamps of fault current let through. So if we look over at our one line, we can see that up here we're going to have 100,000 amps of fault current on this bus right here. And then we're going to have an 800 amp fuse, and that this fuse is only going to let through about 22,000 amps of symmetrical fault current. So then down here, this bus, we really just have to be concerned with the 22,000 fault current amps because of the current limiting 800 amp fuse above it in the system. So really, this fuse here is providing two different types of protection to the system downstream. One, it's limiting the let through fault current that's coming through. And then two, of course, over here, as we discussed, it'll also be disconnecting the circuit from the system after a given time. So if we had 100,000 amps fault current, and this is our 800 amp fuse, we can see that the 100,000 exceeds the instantaneous trip time. So in a little over half a cycle, basically, this fuse is going to melt, and prior to that, it's going to let through around 22,000 symmetrical amps of fault current.